out of depression. I'm sitting here trying to at least hold on to still believe in Jesus and believe in the blood and believe in Christianity. And God is talking to you and not me. See, this can really rip you apart. And if you're not careful, this could cause depression. See, I know we like to think that only human interference could cause depression. But when God isn't talking and you don't know why, you could get depressed about it because you thought he loved you. And the question is now to the thinker, why is there an issue with his silence? What's so wrong with God being quiet? And I'll tell you what it is. See, the issue and the problem we have with God being silent is, unfortunately, we associate a lot of the acts of God with the acts of people. In many cases, we are influenced by how we look at God and look at when he talks and look at how he talks and look at if he talks. On the basis of what happened with people, on the basis of how people played things, on the basis of how people responded to things, we connect those things to God. Meaning, if somebody got quiet because they was mad, typically when God get quiet, we think he is mad. And when you go to people with problems saying, hey, I need $4,500. I'm about to get put out of my apartment. I'm about to get put out of my home. My kid's about to get kicked out of school. We got to pay this. Can you help me? And when they respond to you with silence, typically I would say, go ask somebody else. Because their silence is helping you to understand that they're in thought about whether or not they're going to help you. That they're in thought about, truth be told, how to even tell you no. And we take that and put those shades on and we look at God through the lens of what another man did to us. And that's the problem that we have with God's silence. We assume God's silence means the same thing as when a man is silent, but God said something different to Samuel. He told Samuel, let me tell you something, because you picked David's older brother, but I picked David. He said, man looks on the outer appearance. He said, but I look on the heart. He told Isaiah, y'all know that scripture. Y'all got to know that scripture. He told him in specifics, he said, my ways are not your ways. He said, my thoughts are not your thoughts. He said, for as high as the heavens are to the earth, so art my thoughts to your thoughts and my ways to your ways. In other words, a man could do the same thing God could do, but it's on another level. It means that a man could mimic God, but when God does what a man do, it's foot levels above it. When God acts, when God moves, you can't compare it to a man because it's taller than a man. It's stronger than a man. It's higher than a man. And I present to you that it's possible.